So irrigation as well, aware that we are blessed with rain god as well as environmental god. We have got very good shower, especially for this year also and the years to come. Tamil Nadu is blessed with good location specific environment. So here we are getting more amount of rain in order to recharge our groundwater as well as surface water in order to protect our crop lands. However, so many reasons due to the population explosion, need to produce more, so many demands, some of the times the global warming and climate change also play a vital role in the proper use of water. Water is an essential resource or vital resource for any crop production. So irrigation is nothing but artificial application of water to the land in order to increase the crop lands in the absence of adequate amount of moisture, especially through rainwater. So we have got different methods by which we are giving irrigation to our crops. One is surface irrigation, subsurface irrigation, and automatic irrigation, sprinkler irrigation, manual irrigation, drip irrigation. So different kinds of irrigation we are following based on the crop needs, soil type, and the environment of the particular location. So as well aware that the old system of irrigation is called the flood method irrigation. Here we are using enormous amount of water we are wasting. We are applying the water more than the crop requirement. The crop is not efficient because it will not take the water as like the fish. The crop is a crop which requires optimum amount of water in order to perform its production. We are thinking that when you give more amount of water, the crop will produce more. It not so for all the cases, in all the locations, in all the soils. So in the normal, the traditional system of irrigation, we are wasting most of our water, precious water. So now the situation warrants we need to go for root irrigation or root level irrigation, or still further we need to go for xylem irrigation in future. You take it from me. In future, instead of giving the root zone irrigation, we need to give the irrigation only directly to the xylem vessel, so that we will be saving 95% of water requirement. Okay, at present we are concentrating more on micro irrigation. Why? Because if you look at the water use efficiency of different countries, right from Israel to other countries, Israel is the world leader where it's having the water use efficiency of more than 80%. Then compared to India, all other countries like India, Malaysia and Thailand, their water efficiency was very high. So what we have to do? We are in a position to improve our water use efficiency. At the same time, we need to produce more. The only solution is going for pressurized irrigation system or micro irrigation. If you look at the irrigation efficiency in different systems, for example, the flood irrigation, where the irrigation efficiency is only 32%. You see, you are flooding all over the cropped area. So here we need to irrigate only the root zone. Here what we are doing, instead that we are flooding entire cropped area, so that the unwanted area also get wetted. Because of this, we are facing a lot of problem like nutrient mobilization, leaching, and also growth of the unwanted growth of weeds. Then coming to the furrow irrigation, wherein we can slightly improve the water use efficiency or irrigation efficiency, 45%. Then when you go for pressurized irrigation like rain gun, 50%, there is a still better use. Then when you go for sprinkler irrigation, 60%. Then micro sprinkler, 80%. When you go for drip irrigation, you can able to improve the irrigation efficiency to the level of 90%. Then if you look at the SWOT analysis for drip penetration, especially in Tamil Nadu, so the major strength is strong governmental support. Both state and central government is giving enormous amount of fund to popularize this micro irrigation in Tamil Nadu. Then we have got a wide extension network by combining all the departments like agriculture department, horticulture department, agriculture engineering department. They are shouldering all the responsibility to spread the technology with the university also. Then higher use efficiency of inputs by using this drip irrigation. then the government is spending nearly crores of money in terms of subsidy to the fertilizer. So we can go for drip irrigation as well as drip fertigation systems. But then if you look at the opportunities, it's well aware that we are short of water requirement. Previously, the share for water for agriculture is more than 90%. So due to the stiff competition by the industry, then domestic use and also growing population, we need a lot of water. So they are competing our irrigation share. The share water for agriculture is reducing year after year. So we need to go for pressurized irrigation. That is a major opportunity. We have to use it. The water inadequacy. And then due to monsoon failure many of the time, due to the global warming and the climate change, then we are in a position to produce more food in order to feed the hungry stomach. Then we are also well versed in a different IT. There are different systems, tools we are using for IT, tools we are using for extraction technologies. So we are having the advanced research in nutrient and water management. So this is our opportunity. Then the weakness, as you are aware, fragmented land holdings. That is a major drawback. So if you take the Tamil Nadu, nearly 85% of the area is small farmers. The farmers are very small farmers. The holdings are very less than 1 hectare. Then higher capital cost. When you go for the drip irrigation or pressurized irrigation, the capital cost is very high. Then many of the farmers is having the skeptical attitude. I'm having water. If you go to Tanjavur and other area, they used to say, whenever you approach for TNIA in this scheme, we are giving free 100% subsidy to farmers, especially for banana farmers, sugarcane farmers. They are not willing to take for this micro irrigation. Why? Because we are having adequate water. Why should I go for micro irrigation? Why should I invest for some money for the farmers' contribution? So that kind of skeptical attitude they are having. And then some of the weakness also, we are not having the proper MOU between the company and also the drip companies as well as the farmers' usage. Most often, the drip irrigation system goes failure. Then installation gets delayed. That's why the farmer is also facing a lot of problem. That is a major weakness of the system. But then challenges, timely coordination among the agencies. It needs to be improved. Time-bound completion of task is needed. System service and maintenance. We need to give the system maintenance contract at the same time when we are giving the micro irrigation. Whenever we give the subsidy to the farmer, we also put the maintenance with the same company. We need to allot some 5 to 6% of the basic amount to the company so that it will be well maintained. Then uniform pricing of the components, then using of the drip components full of its life system. We are not using the drip system until it's a lifetime, until it's full use of lifetime. For example, whenever I give the drip irrigation system for a farmer, he will use for 3 or 4 seasons, that's all. Thereafter, it keeps in other places. They are not using properly. So we need use. That is a major challenge we are facing. So coming to the irrigation potential, what is being created in Tamil Nadu and being utilized. If you look at in India, the ultimate irrigation potential of the country, that is EIP, is 140 million hectare, out of which 114 million hectare has been created. Irrigation potential is being created. And the irrigation potential of 88 million hectare has been utilized. So as per the Planning Commission, as per the Ministry of Agriculture, the IPU, the irrigation potential utilized is only 65 million hectare. So 60% of the irrigation is covered under groundwater resources, and a large section of the farmers are still dependent on the groundwater for agriculture. Therefore, it is more important to bridge the gap of IPC and also IPU, that is a use and also the creations. And then coming to the pressurized irrigation, let us see the different system of irrigation, especially the micro irrigation. We'll see the drip irrigation. The name itself indicates trickle irrigation. Water is delivered nearer to the root zone of the crop by drop by drop. So thereby we can have the improved water use efficiency. At the same time, we can able to give the herbicide or pesticide, sometimes we can give, and also it is capable of giving fertilizer also. So drip fertigation is also possible. Then when we go for combined use of plastic mulch, it is also possible to go for all the system one to one, so that we can have the better crop production, better water use efficiency. Then if you look at the drip irrigation system actually laid in the surface and subsurface drip irrigation system, you very well see the wetting pattern. You see, it's a uniformly wetted the region. Then you may not be aware what will happen below the soil surface when we wet the soil through drip irrigation. If you see the below the water surface, what will happen when you go for border strip irrigation? The water movement mostly vertically downward when you go for border strip irrigation. When you go for furrow irrigation, you can see the water movement both downward as well as sideways. You can see the arrow mark. And also when you go for the sprinkler irrigation, water movement both vertically and downwards. So simply what it happens when you go for surface and the sprinkler irrigation, it is nothing but your piston flow system of water movement. When you go for drip irrigation system, it is a capillary flow. You see, drip by drip, the water is added to the soil, whether it is a subsurface or surface. You see the moisture contour. First drop, then second drop, third drop, like that. The wetting width will be slightly enhancing time to time. So this is the wetting pattern of a different irrigation system. So one thing I want to give the basic principles. இங்க தான் நமக்கு புரிதல் வேணும். அதாவது தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறத விட புரிஞ்சுக்கிறது ரொம்ப நல்லது. ஸோ இந்த ட்ரிப் ஸ்பேசிங்கில் நம்ம வந்து ட்ரிப்பர்ஸ் வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் போத் இன்லைன் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ தி ஆன்லைன். ஸோ இப்போ ஒவ்வொரு ட்ரிப்லையும் வரக்கூடிய தண்ணி என்ன பண்ணணும்னா, இந்த பெர்குலேட்டர் வாட்டர், இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் தி வைடர் ஸ்பேசிங் ஆஃப் தி ட்ரிப்பர் ஸ்பேசிங், திஸ் வில் ஹேப்பன் பிலோ தி சாயில். வைடர் ஸ்பேசிங், சப்போஸ் ஃபார் இட் இஸ் ஏ சாண்டி சாயில், வென் வி கீப் த ட்ரிப்பர் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் அட் ஏ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் மோர் தென் 60 centimeter, திஸ் வில் ஹேப்பன். See, the root system is here. When you are applying the water, this is the zone of wetting. You see, the zone of wetting, so only part of the root system is covered and the remaining part is not covered. So when you irrigate more time, especially for 2 hours or 3 hours, the water will not move this side. The water will go downward only, especially in light textured soil. So the basic principle here involved is the percolated water droplets must join together before it reaching the end of the root zone. See, this is the root zone. Before it touches the end of the root zone, these droplets should join together. That is a basic principle. In the vishayatha nam purinjikittomna, the dripper spacing eppadi calculate pannum different soils appadi nam paathukalam. So that the dripper spacing should be fixed for the different soil types. So this is the correct question, this is the wrong question. Because we may not be aware that how the water wetting pattern will be. See that it's a beautifully wetted. So this is a system, this is a thing we have to follow. When we follow the things, the chance of occurrence of failure is very, very less. Then if you look at the soil type and water movement, the application of water is by the drippers. You can see the sandy soil. This all, we cannot see, this will happen below the soil surface. In the case of a sandy soil, the drip water droplets will move this section only. Even if you irrigate 3 hours or 4 hours, the distribution, the sidewards will not be there. We are going to waste the water. The downward movement alone will happen. When you go for giving the same kind of irrigation, the medium soil, you see the spread, the wetting zone. When you go for clay soil, you see the wetting zone. So this is the basic principle one should understand. Then another most important advantage of going for a drip irrigation is giving fertilizer through irrigation drip, that is called a drip fertigation. You see, the fertilizer molecules, when you apply over the soil and give with the surface irrigation, normally we will be applying the fertilizer over the surface of the soil, then immediately we'll irrigate. Soon after irrigation, this will happen in the soil system. You see the leaching. Most of the nutrients will be congregated in the top layer itself. Then some of the nutrients percolate down along with the water molecules. When you irrigate more, the fertilizer also go into the deeper layer, that we, through the leaching of water. So that nutrients cannot be taken by the plants. it will go into the deeper layer. Then when you apply the fertilizer over the soil and irrigate through drip irrigation, that is a fertilizer application is different and the irrigation through drip. So here you can see the localized fertilizer movement. Here the movement is, it is not uniformly distributed. When you go for drip fertigation, we are using the water soluble fertilizer, that is costly one. We are already dissolving the fertilizer within the with the water. When we apply through drip, the drip fertigation, you see the nutrients are very easily are distributed uniformly below the soil surface nearer to the root zone, because we are giving optimum quantity of water which wet only the root zone. So the nutrients are also distributed nearer to the root zone, thereby we can improve the water use efficiency. At the same time, we can also use the fertilizer use efficiency. When you go for using this kind of nitrogenous fertilizer through water soluble fertilizer, the drip fertigation, the fertilizer use efficiency will be 95%. When you use the same nitrogen, when you apply through the soil, over the surface soil, when give drip irrigation, it is only 65%. Similarly, when you apply the nitrogenous fertilizer and over the surface and application of water through flood irrigation, the fertilizer use efficiency will be between 30 to 50% only. Similarly, for phosphorus and potassium, all the nutrient use efficiency will be increased when you go for drip fertigation. Then there are special quality of fertilizer grades are available to supply the crops. This also not only supply the major nutrients and also supply the micronutrients in different levels. When you go for polyfeed, R19, along with 1000 ppm of iron, and also similarly different categories of fertilizer we are using for matching the crop demand. So then 500 ppm of manganese, 75 ppm of zinc, 200 ppm of boron, 35 ppm of molybdenum, copper, everything can be combined with this major nutrient so that we can very easily apply the fertilizer to the crop nearer to the roots. Then another important thing, நான் உங்களுக்கு வந்து புரிஞ்சுக்கிறதுக்கு சொல்கிறேன், தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறத விட புரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டீங்கன்னா நல்லாயிருக்கு. திஸ் ஃபார் அந்த கேட்டகரியில் வரது அந்த ஃபில்டர் ஃபார் ட்ரிப் இரிகேஷன். ஸோ மோஸ்ட்லி வென் யூ கிவ் தி தெர் ஆர் திஸ் இஸ் சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர், திஸ் இஸ் டிஸ் ஃபில்டர், ஹைட்ரோசைக்ளோன் ஃபில்டர், ஸ்க்ரீன் ஃபில்டர், ஸ்க்ரீன் ஃபில்டர். ஸோ இன் தி சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் இட் இஸ் வெரி காஸ்ட்லி, இட் வில் பி அரவுண்ட் 12,000 to 15,000. So depending upon the company and other things. So you see, it will be more than 12,000. Then price will be, it will be around 7,000. It will be around 4,500 and 5,000. It will be around 2,500 and 3,000. That's all. So where we have to use? பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சில இடத்துல வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா போரில் தண்ணி வர்றப்பே போரோட தண்ணியோட நிறைய மண் வரும். ஸோ அது போர் தண்ணி மண் வந்துச்சுன்னா டெஃபினெட்லி இட் வில் கிளாக் தி சிஸ்டம். அப்போ எந்த ஃபில்டர் போடணும்? நிறைய பேர் என்ன பார்த்தீங்கன்னா தெரியாத சமயத்தில் சேண்டு நிறைய வருது, சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் போட்டாங்க. சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் போட்டிங்கன்னா என்னாகனா இந்த ஃபில்டர் சிஸ்டம் வில் நாட் ஒர்க் ப்ராப்பர்லி. சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் எல்லாருமே பார்த்துருப்பீங்க, அந்த சேண்ட் ஃபில்டரில் இருக்கக்கூடிய மீடியாவில் இந்த சேண்டு போய் படிஞ்சிருக்கிறது என்னன்னா அகெயின் இட் வில் கிளாக் தி சிஸ்டம். ஸோ அந்த சேண்ட் அதிகமாக வர இடத்துக்கு இந்த ஃபில்டர் போடக்கூடாது, ஹைட்ரோசைக்ளோன் ஃபில்டர் மட்டும்தான் போடணும். இந்த ஹைட்ரோசைக்ளோன் ஃபில்டர் போடுறப்ப என்ன ஆரம்பிச்சுன்னா, ஸோ திஸ் வில் ரிமூவ் தி சேண்ட் காம்போனன்ட். ஸோ சிமிலர்லி இந்த டிஸ்க் ஃபில்டர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சேண்ட் ஃபில்டரும் டிஸ்க் ஃபில்டரும் எந்த இடத்துல போடணும் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, வென் தெர் இஸ் எனார்மஸ் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல்கல் க்ரோத், நீங்கள் தண்ணி எடுத்து ஒரு தொட்டியில் வச்சுட்டு அப்புறம் இரிகேஷன் போகிறப்ப என்னென்னா ஆல்கல் க்ரோத் நிறையா இருக்கும், ஹை அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆர்கானிக் மேட்டர் இருக்கும். எஸ்பெஷலி வென் யூ யூஸ் தி சீவேஜ் வாட்டர், சிவேஜ் வாட்டரில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஹை அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆர்கானிக் மேட்டர் இருக்கும். அந்த மாதிரி இருக்கலாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா வி ஹாவ் டு யூஸ் சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட், தட் இஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபில்டர் சேண்ட் ஃபில்டர் யூஸ் பண்ணும், டிஸ்க் ஃபில்டர் யூஸ் பண்ணும், இஃப் நீட் பி யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ கோ ஃபார் ஸ்க்ரீன் ஃபில்டர். இதை மாதிரி இருந்தால் தான் உங்களுக்கு வந்து நல்லா ஒர்க் பண்ணும். இல்லைன்னா நான் ட்ரிப் இரிகேஷன் போட்டேன் எனக்கு சரியாக வரல, அங்கேருந்து கிளாக்கிங் இருக்குன்னு தான் சொல்லிட்டு இருக்கோம். ஸோ ஒன் ஷுட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வென் டு யூஸ் அண்ட் வேர் டு யூஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட்டு ஃபில்டர்ஸ். சில இடத்துல பார்த்தீங்கன்னா தண்ணி நல்லாயிருக்கும், சுத்தமாக இருக்கும், மண் வராது, ஆர்கானிக் மேட்டர் கம்மியாக இருக்கும், ஆல்கல் க்ரோத்தே இருக்காது, போர் வாட்டர் நல்லாயிருக்கும், ஹார்ட் ராக்கில் போர் போட்டிருப்பீங்க, அதில் கொஞ்சம் கூட மண்ணே வராதுன்னா வி கேன் கோ ஒன்லி ஃபார் ஸ்க்ரீன் ஃபில்டர். இட் இஸ் வெரி வெரி லெஸ் காஸ்ட். so that it will not have more cost to the farmer. So in such case you can go for screen filter. So other situation போறப்ப காஸ்ட குறைக்கிறேன் சொல்லிட்டு then the system will not work properly. So that we have to understand properly. Then as you are aware that what are the advantages of going for micro irrigation? Higher crop yields, no doubt. Higher water use efficiency. Then we can minimize the fertilizer requirement for the crop by way of increasing the fertilizer use efficiency. Then less labor requirement, no doubt. Reduces the salt concentration in the soil, because we are giving only less amount of water to the soil. Thereby, we are reducing the salt concentration in the soil. It controls many of the diseases also. Then reduce the weed growth, because we are irrigating only to the root zone where water is required. Then the major setback or disadvantage is the clogging effect. Then initial cost involvement. Then damage by the rodents. Then salinity. Then root development when you go for subsurface irrigation. And also maintenance. That is also another problem. So when you come across all these problems, I think drip irrigation system works very well. So even when you go for the drip irrigation system for aerobic rice, so many people may still have their confusion that when you go for whether we can go for aerobic rice with the drip irrigation. Yes, it is possible. We have conducted many trials. So you also, what is aerobic soil? It's a non-saturated soil without ponding of water, where we raise the rice crop is called aerobic rice. Aerobic rice cultivation is a production system which involves the growing of specially developed varieties with the input responsive rice varieties in well-drained, non-puddled, non-saturated soils without ponded water. So here, our aim is not to achieve more than 10 tonnes or 12 tonnes. So here, we need to achieve the moderate level of yield to the tune of 4 to 6 tonnes per hectare. So you see the drip layout in the rice crop. So when you see the root system, when you go for aerobic rice in the drip irrigation system, this is the drip fertigated crop with very good established root system. And the yield also very high when you go for drip irrigation system compared to conventional aerobic. Then you can see the water use efficiency. The water applied was nearly, we can use only 674 mm. The conventional aerobic, when you go for surface drip, we are using 608, and subsurface we are using the same quantity. You see the water productivity. The water productivity is increasing when you go for drip irrigation rather than conventional aerobic rice. So many of the people will be knowing from this area, Amaravati sub-basin, the drip fertigation study was conducted by TNIU and also the company. So here we are used CR1009 and the JKRH333 variety. We have selected 12 hectares of area. The average we have attained for CR1000 is 5 tonnes per hectare, whereas in the case of JKRH333, 3.4 tonnes per hectare. You can see the crop. Almost most of the extension officials also visited. Our APC also visited here. So here we have recorded another farmer's field in Govindapuram, Mr. Parthasarathi field. He has recorded outstanding yield of 12 tonnes per hectare, 12.5 tonnes per hectare in rice variety CR1009. It is possible. So we have conducted several field days. Govindapuram again. Then here we have achieved a 6.6 tonnes average yield per hectare. The water saving was nearly 40%. Then drip irrigation system in Satyamangalam. Then similarly for as well aware that drip can be extended a wide range of crops. Almost all the crops we can extend. Not only for agriculture crops and horticulture crops and tree crops we can extend. So we have got very good results and encouraging results in all the crops, especially in the maize also. We can able to achieve 8.9 tonnes per hectare when you go for drip irrigation system with fertigation schedule. Then sugarcane. Sustainable sugarcane initiative. Yet another technology is being evaluated and perfected by TNIU. Here, we achieved a tremendous yield. Many of the agricultural officials might be knowing his name, Mr. Purasami. He is belonging to Perangiyur, Vilupuram district. He has received an exemplary award from our former CM, Madam. She has given a very good appreciation and also the award to the farmer because he has achieved a tremendous yield. He has achieved nearly 267 tons per hectare of area with sugarcane, COC 24. So this is a tremendous yield. It's nobody has outbeaten this yield. So such a wonderful crop, you can appreciate the crop. When you go for drip irrigation along with fertigation, it is possible to achieve the yield. And also the groundnut, we can able to achieve nearly 4 tons per hectare when you go for drip irrigation along with fertigation. Then cotton, we can achieve out yielding of nearly 2.25 tons per hectare with a seed cotton yield. In the case of tapioca also, we can achieve 45 tons per hectare. Here, we are not only aiming for achieving the higher yield, at the same time, our aim is to reduce the water retention. Because water is more precious, we need to conserve the water, it's a need of the hour. So our aim is not only improving yield, but also increasing the water efficiency. Then black gram, you see the video of black gram. The crop is still in the field. Anybody want to visit, especially in Coimbatore, Erode, Salem region, you play the video. You can appreciate the crop of green gram as well as the black gram. So it is right now the crop is in the field stand. I can show you some of your agriculture officials also, and last week our director seeds also visited this plot. Next. In the photo pole. So what I'm trying to say, because I don't want to give all the facts and figures, it is proven. When you go for micro irrigation, the yield of the any crop will be improved. When you combine the fertilizer application through irrigation, that is called fertigation, definitely it will improve the fertilizer efficiency. We can achieve both in a single stroke. So what is the current trend now? We can go for what is the advancement in irrigation. So as you are aware, everything so far I have told here, the new thing is automation. The automation is nothing but automation of drip or micro irrigation system refers to the operation of the system with no or minimum manual intervention. Irrigation automation is well justified where a large area to be irrigated is divided into small segments called irrigation blocks, and these segments are irrigated in sequence in order to match the flow of water or available water from the water resource. So we are sequentially distributing the entire area, converting to different irrigation blocks. We can give the irrigation till the crop end by way of using the computer program. We need not go to the field, we can able to give the irrigation anywhere in the world. So it is fully automated, we can apply the water, we can also apply the fertigation schedule. Everything is automated so that we can also monitor through your cell phone. There is a app, separate app is available. So here also, in TNA also, we have to install our drip automation system, both for fresh water as well as sewage treated water. So wherein I can able to see which valve is opened now, which field is irrigating now, how much time they are irrigating, when the valve number one is closed, when the valve number two is closed, open, like that. We can see all the information through our mobile app. Whether you are in India, whether you are in abroad, you can able to monitor very well about our irrigation system by way of proper planning. So the system of automation also work on different system, time-based irrigation system, volume-based irrigation system, and open-loop system, closed-loop system, real-time feedback system, computer-based irrigation control system, sensor-controlled micro-irrigation. So we have got a variety of choice. Suppose I want to irrigate my crop only for 2 hours, between 2 to 4, it is possible. I want to give my crop 20,000 liters per hectare. That is a volume base. It is possible. I want to irrigate my crop whenever the soil moisture touches 25%. So it is possible. I want to control my irrigation whenever the water level touches the saturation point of the soil. it is possible. So like that, we can automate our irrigation system by way of designing our things. So once it is installed, the irrigation system has to be controlled all the time. So modern big scale system is operated by one skilled labor, that's all. So very technical components required. There are even high technological solution by using the GIS and the satellite to measure the water needs. Time-based system, again, the same thing. I don't know what this. Then this is the way I can still show you in the subsequent slide how the automation works in our university. Then coming to the sprinkler irrigation, water is distributed through a system of pipes, usually by pumping and spraying heads at the outlets, distribute the water over the entire soil surface. That is telepaneer possible. This system, especially large ones, are mostly automated. It can be found in small vegetable gardens up to large crop fields. Therefore, several systems can be deployed. The sprinkler heads, different systems, the sprinkler layer, then sprinkler heads, one system, center pivot system, linear move system, traveling big gun system, side roll irrigation sprinkler system, that we can see. Here you can see the normal sprinkler. Here, I'll give the video. You can completely drench the soil. You can completely drench the soil. The crop and the riser pipe height can be adjusted so that it can be used for short crop, medium crop, even tall crops also we can use this. Then center pivot to boom sprinkler. It is a self-propelled sprinkler system. It rotates around the pivot point. You can see either this can rotate the entire area or this can move in this direction. So the amount of water applied is controlled by the moving speed. So when you move slowly, the water spread is very uniform. It wets the entire area. So this is seldomly used in India. So some of the area, some estate crops being used here. For any crop height and especially suited for light soil and a low labor requirement. Then the end gun installed at the end of the sprinkler bar is able to reach the corners. So both end we can, the water being supplied, this can be given all the entire field area so that the entire crop can be wetted. Then linear move, the name itself indicates that the moving towards the pipes, interconnecting the towers, which moves at the same time, same speed, in the same direction. It's moving forward. So the water is pumped into the center or end of the system. The source will be either the center of the point or at the end of the point. Thereby we can give the irrigation system. Then traveling big gun. The big gun system uses high water pressure and a large capacity nozzle. The gun is connected either a hot or a flexible hose and it's pulled towards the water source. You can see when it moves, it will sprinkle the water everywhere. The maximum area to irrigate range from 0.3 to 0.4 square kilometer per gun. So it is being widely used. The previous one also widely used. This one also widely used in India. But then if you look at the big gun, you put the video show. So one can very well appreciate how it discharges the water.
Coşuyorlar bu bari.
Bak, net. Bak. Kaç mı? Net. Then traveling sprinkler, you can see that the flexible hose is attached so that it's like a traveling kit. it can move from both direction, both backward and forward, so that it can wet the entire area. You can see the wetting pattern from here to here. The entire end can cover more than 70-80 meters. It can cross depending upon the flow of water and the pressure they are given. Then rain gun. Next. Then the LOCAST technology, many people might have seen. Whenever you come to main campus in front of the Vice Chancellor building, the entire field is covered with this rain hoses. Just like rain, it wet the entire soil. You see, it is a very, very low cost technology by the KSNM drip company. Is situated in Coimbatore. For 1 hectare, we can able to cover at the cost of even 25,000 to 30,000 rupees. We can cover the entire 1 hectare. Here, we need not have any kind of filter. Filter is not at all required. It is a by using the it's a laser hose also, we can say. By using the laser, they are making the holes. Each hole will deliver 9 liters per hour, so that it can wet the entire area. It's a low cost system. This can be used for wide range of crops, even paddy, then your all kinds of pulses, and also your onion. Everything they are using now, it is catching up very well. They are exporting for more than 18 countries. They cannot be able to supply the demand because low cost, very less maintenance. The thing is, here, the basic principle, the application of water, what we are saying in the drip irrigation is, drip by drip we are adding. Here we are wetting pattern is very fast. So that's why it is not being taken up, because it's a very low cost material. The lifetime will be, they are saying that for 1.5 years to 2 years, but there is a lot of possibilities for damage by rats and also the dogs. So when we protect from this damage, we can very well use for more than a year. It's a very, very low cost technology. Then side roll, by moving a roll, the water gets supplied entire field. Then coming to drip automation facilities, which is available in the Water Technology Center in Coimbatore. So you can see this is our automation unit. Here the wind velocity, maximum temperature, we are studying wind velocity and also the humidity, the rainfall of a particular place, where we can get all the data. We have got everything is installed. The automatic evaporation and the computation, automatic duration and the quantity of water application. We can calculate both quantity of water and the time duration. Then automatic filter washing. Normally we go for backwashing manually. Here everything is automated. Then automatic electronic conductivity of pH of fertilizer that can be adjusted. Then that pH of fertilizer being mixed with water and it's being maintained. We have got separate tanks for different kinds of fertilizer, N fertilizer, P and K. So according to the crop demand, as well aware that the nitrogen requirement of crop will vary from time to time. During the early part of the time, it requires more amount of phosphorus and also the nitrogen. The potassium requirement will be less. So when the crop nearing to the flowering period, the nitrogen requirement will be reduced. Whereas after flowering, the requirement of P as well as K is enhanced. So when you supply the nutrients according to the crop demand, definitely we can improve the crop yield. So that's why we can have a different tank system of different kinds of fertilizer, so that we can automate when to apply nitrogenous fertilizer, when to apply the phosphorus, when to apply the potash, as well as the micronutrients that can be mixed together by balancing the pH of this media and sent to the crop directly. So in the case of normal system manual recording, when you want to work out the ET, evapotranspiration, it is a tedious process, where everyone knows that. We need to take all the parameters and work out the crop ETC, and thereby we have to compete for the evapotranspiration estimation. Whereas in the case of automation, we have got everything within the inbuilt system, wherein we can study the real-time current temperature of the field, and the humidity level, wind speed, wind direction, solar radiation, carbon dioxide level, then pH, EC, and also what is the rainfall received, water quantity, fertilizer quantity, everything is the data is inbuilt here so that it will operate on its own. So based on this input data, the output also given to the system, thereby we can very easily facilitate or very easily monitor the water application as well as drip fertigation schedule for the entire crop. Once if you automate, we need not to see the water requirement of the crop and also fertilizer requirement of crop until the harvest. Everything is done automatically. I think many of the extension officials might have visited in Dindigul, Reddiyar Satram area. There, they are having this kind of facilities, greenhouse nursery, wonderful system they are having. The automation system they are having, it is working very nicely. We also visited along with my students. So we visited, they are maintained very nicely. One must see. If at all anybody has not seen that place, it is worth seeing. Go and see how they are maintaining the irrigation, especially for nursery crop. They are fully automated. They are giving irrigation as well as fertigation. It is a over the top of the ceilings, it is sprays. It will move front and forward direction. Thereby, whenever the moisture levels get reduced, automatically it on, it moves both backward and forward level. Whenever the moisture level reaches the optimum level, it stops on its own. So thereby we can able to produce quality seedlings, healthy seedlings. Then we can also use the soil moisture sensor based automation. So we can fix the critical limit. Whenever the lowest limit and highest limit, whenever the soil reaches the lowest limit of soil moisture, the drip irrigation system automatically opens. And when it reaches the saturation point, automatically it cuts off the irrigation system. Thereby we can have a better irrigation management. Then so many latest technologies, they are going for a gravel sandless culture by way of giving the nutrient solution. This another method you can see in 5-star hotels everywhere, they are maintaining this. It's a costly one. Then another thing is aquaponics. People are so crazy about this system, aquaponics, wherein we can use costly vegetables as well as flowers as well as leafy vegetables we can grow. In this system you can see, this is the pipe wherein we are supplying the nutrient solution. The root system will touches the water, the media for nutrients. The nutrients media will be flowing, freely flowing within the pipes. This pipe here may be a round type. You can see here it is a flat type. So different types can be used. You can see the growth of the lush growth of the leaf vegetable. So mostly it's supplied in the 5-star hotels as well as for the party or any functions they are supplying. You can see different media filter we are using. In the filter, if you keep the plant, the root system is well developed, it touches the nutrient system, the nutrients will be moving, slowly moving from one end to another end. Then every day it is being balanced. So the pH is being balanced, the nutrient level also being tested, monitored. It is a tedious process, but however, it is a worth spending. We can able to produce very healthy leafy vegetables or another vegetables. Then another one is aeroponics. In the aeroponics, the root system will not directly come in contact with the nutrient solution. So there is a clear cut space between the root system as well as the nutrient media. Here, by using the pressure pump, it will spray the nutrient media nearer in the root zone. When it rotates, it will sprinkle the nutrient media, the roots, thereby it gets nutrients from the solution, thereby it grows. This is also growing very well. You see the growth. Here there is no media, you can see the root system. So here it is touches the nutrient solution. Here it will not touch the nutrient solution, the nutrient solution will be sprinkled to the nearer to the roots. So coming to the drip system simulation software. So as of now we have seen what is the system, what are the advancement system in different irrigation pattern. So we want to calibrate as an irrigation engineer, we want to know how the system works. In order to know how the system will perform after it's installed. Suppose if you are installing a drip irrigation system in a clay soil, we want to see actually how the water flow in the irrigation system. when you download a software developed by WTC, Dr. Ravi Kumar, the system is still being available in the website. If you download that software, you can find it out. We can also see the changing the design to see the variation in the performance. Suppose if you want to give different irrigation system or different level of pressure, how it moves below the soil, that can also be seen. Then we can also arriving a cost effective design. In order to go for reducing the cost, we can also make use of the design before employing the design into the soil. It is free software. You can see the software can be downloaded at www.ena.ac.in/wtc/dp.html. So here you can able to give the two softwares simulate drip subunit, how the subunit can be laid out below the soil, and then software for designing the drip mains. So both main and sub mains can be altered. Thereby we can reduce the cost of laying the system.